How would you like to build your own hotwire CNC foam cutter using inexpensive 3D printer components and parts you can easily find down your local DIY store? So this is a US Navy T-45 goshawk that I made, and the wings and fuselage were all made with the hotwire CNC foam cutter. And it's not the largest of models, but I have built a much bigger Hawk Hurricane. And it was all made using a machine very similar to this one. This is my latest machine, which is a USB version running with 3D printer electronics, and these are all the parts that you're required to make it. So surely it's cheaper to buy foam models than building with an expensive CNC machine like this. Well, yeah, it can be to start with, but some of the big EDF jets made from foam can be quite expensive. I've seen a few crash beyond repair at my flying club, and the first flying wing I built with this machine flew fantastic until I crashed it. Well, I crashed it a few times, but the last one was its final one. So power up the machine, cut some new wing cores, and I was back in the air a few days. So here's that flying wing with a Mobius camera on the front to get a bit of onboard footage, and as you can see, it flies great. So it's probably a lot cheaper to buy flying wings, but once you've been making a few, then it starts to really pay for itself. So how much is it going to cost you to build this hotwire CNC foam cutter? Well, I'm recording this video in July 2019, and a quick check on the latest prices. You can probably build it for about $200, £160, or about €180. But if you'd like to build the parallel port version, then that's going to cost you around about 30% more. The software to run a CNC controller is free, and there is free software to generate the G-code for a wing, but there is paid software as well, which is a bit more comprehensive, which I'll talk about a little bit later in the video. Another reason is to build models that you can't buy, or if you could, it would be very expensive. I really enjoy researching and designing my own, and there's some great software you can use now. I have a few videos on the channel showing how to use some of this software, and I've got a few more planned for the future. So if this is something you might be interested in, guys, I've created a full set of plans, a new ebook, and this will be the first in the four-part video series showing you how to build a machine from start to finish. So I'll just explain what we're going to cover in this four-part video series. So part one is introduction, which you're looking at now. And in part two, we'll go on to the electronics. And what we'll do is we'll get all these stepper motors and controller cards mocked up on the bench and tested. Part three, we'll do the mechanical build. That'll be quite a lengthy video. And then in part four, we'll do our first cut with a bit of calibration and testing before that. So I've been making foam aeroplanes with my machine for several years now, but it was using outdated hardware. And I got quite a few requests from people saying, can they use laptops and USB? So I thought it was time to design a new one to work with modern computers and laptops. So I've been working on this design for about 9 months, and I've used my experience in foam cutting to design the new machine. So it could be simple to build with these plans, and most of them are templates, so you just lay them over the wood and then mark where the holes are and drill them out, and it's fairly straightforward. So I've put a lot of research into this, and it's been designed in Fusion 360, the 3D modeling software, to make sure everything works okay. So there's going to be four videos. This first one is going to be more of an introduction and an overview of the build process and what we're going to use. The second video is going to be the electronics. So what we're going to do is make sure we get the electronics working first. So we'll get the stepper motors and that mocked up on the bench and make sure they all work. And then we'll go into the actual mechanical build, which will be probably the third video. And then the fourth video will be the configuration and testing. And then we'll actually cut a little sample wing that's included in the downloads. So you can just put that in with and test it out. So there's links to all the firmware software that's being used, and I've got the firmware configured specifically for this machine. So it should hopefully just work straight out of the box. So in the remainder of the video, I'll go into a bit more detail so you can decide for yourself then if this is something you want to have a go at making. So here we have all the parts ready to build the new hotwire CNC foam cutter. And the reason I'm building a new one really, because I get a lot of feedback on my website and on other videos about, can we use more modern hardware? My old machine, which has been fantastically reliable, has used the old parallel port interface, and there's still a lot of them around, and it's easy to get hold of at the moment, but there might come a time when they, you know, you struggle to get hold of them. So this is the new design, and originally my intention was to just use 3D printer technology, so the small motors and then the controller, which is an Arduino Mega 2560 with a RAMPS 1.4 board on it. My original intention was just to convert my old machine, but my old machine was quite a big machine, and it was built with a lot thicker material. So this is 12mm MDF, and it was all built with 18mm high density MDF, which was quite heavy. Good and solid, but heavy. So to power that, it used NEMA 23 motors, which are, as you can see, they're quite a heavy motor compared to the little NEMA 17 motor. So I did toy with the idea of just converting it, but the problem was I thought these wouldn't be possibly strong enough, and we could probably end up losing steps. So I decided a new design was required. So I spent quite a lot of time on Fusion 360, redesigning the machine to make it easy to build and easy to adjust as well. Because one of the things we have to do is make sure that these threaded rods that we use on the horizontal tower and the vertical tower run parallel, so we don't get any binding. Now on the NEMA 17 stepper motors, we've got these flexible couplers which allow for a little bit of misalignment, but we want to get them as straight as possible, you know, parallel and running true. So the new machine's got quite a lot of adjustment built into the design, as you'll see as we go along. Now some people question why use draw slides and threaded rods. Well, for a foam cutter, it doesn't need to be as accurate as a CNC router or as a 3D printer. We're just cutting foam with a hot wire, and it doesn't need to be within a few thousandths of an inch. You know, if we can get within a half or a quarter of a millimetre, that's more than adequate. Using threaded rods with T-nuts works absolutely fine, and I've built quite a few models. So I've built several foam wings, I've built a Hawker Hurricane, and I've just recently finished a T45 Gosfork, and that's all been done with the CNC machine. And if you look at the pictures I've just put up, you can see that they are absolutely fine. It all goes together fairly simply, and I use these cross dowels on it. I find these work really well. Problem, as you may know, with screws with MDF, if you start to tighten them too much, you can get the fibres start to pull away a bit. Yeah, don't be too put off by the electronic side of it. I've actually already made the video series on how to configure the software, so it's fairly straightforward, and there'll be step-by-step guides how to do that in the ebook as well. So don't let this side frighten you off. It's fairly straightforward, and the plans are all full-size plans apart from these two parts here.
So once you've got the parts cut out and there's a full cutting list included, all you need to do is just drop the plans over on the part and then mark where the holes are, and then drill them out. And I warn you, there's a lot of drilling in this build. But also in the plans, I've included the G-code for the flying wing you saw earlier. So if you want to have a go at building that as your first project, all the setup details and all the G-code's been generated for you. So I hope you found that video useful if you've been thinking about building a CNC foam cutter. And I'll have links to all the resources in the description. And if you do get stuck at all, just drop me a line through YouTube or on the website, and I'm only too glad to help out fellow enthusiasts, and perhaps send some pictures of your machine as well. So thanks for watching, guys. Click subscribe if you want to follow with the series, and we'll see you in the next video.